Hey, we're back with Mechanical Pros. I'm here with Brian. We're going to be talking about field settings and Daikin VRV 4X. Brian, tell me what we got going on today.
Well, we're going to talk about today one of the most commonly used field settings in an outdoor VRV unit. Now, this kind of goes across the board all the way back to Generation 2 VRV, but this particular unit, we're going to talk about the new VRV 4X. This is called forced evacuation / recovery mode. So in other words, if for some reason I had to recover the refrigerant out of this system, it's not like your typical split system you might walk up to and start pulling gas out. All these valves in this unit, some will be in a closed position. Therefore, you're going to have captured refrigerant. You can't get out of the system. If you don't pull it out, you go pull in your vacuum, you're going to have issues. When you go to charge it, it's not going to be a clean system. So we're going to talk about, what do I need to do? I'm walking up to this unit. Let's just say I'm going to change a compressor. I need to recover all of the refrigerant out of this system, and we're going to talk about how to do that setting through the main printed circuit board of the VRV 4X. So the first thing we want to do is make sure it's in the normal mode. So when I walk up to the VRV, any VRV system, I always know it's in normal mode if there's no LEDs or lights on this board. That's normal. It's not going to say okay or give you a happy green light. The lights need to be out. You know that's in the normal mode. The second step I want to do is use technology, which would be my smartphone and the Daikin service app, which will walk me right through it. Now, I've got some years on it. I can do it without that, but I encourage everybody, even seasoned guys, use the app. It's going to keep you from making mistakes. So I've got the app pulled up. I've gone to forced recovery mode through the service app, and this is where it starts me out. You see there's no lights on there, no lights here. That's where I want to be. It walks you right through it. You probably can't read it, but it says this is where you need to be. Swipe for the next step. Next step is hold the mode button down for 5 seconds. I've got three buttons here, mode, set, and reset. I'm going to hold the mode button for 5 seconds, and then I'm going to see that come up. If that does not come up, I've done something wrong. Power's not on the unit, it was in an error code or something like that. Now that I see that come up, easy as enough, you push the next one, then it says press the set button 38 times. Simple, middle button, set it 38 times. A good thing about the VRV4s is it says the number 38. Anybody who's worked on other products before this generation knows that it gives you lights instead of numbers, so this is nice. Now I know I'm in that mode, I've hit 38. Next step, swipe again. Now it says press and hold the test button down for 5 seconds, and then it's going to get up, and that's going to denote is it currently in forced recovery or not. 0 will tell you it's off, 1 will tell you it's on. So because the unit's been in normal, 0, it's not in forced recovery. Swipe it again. Now it has hit the set button once. Now that puts it in 1. That tells me that I've selected forced recovery, but I've not engaged forced recovery mode. All it does is say, now I've selected, I'm in forced recovery. Do you want to move forward? Swipe it again, press the set button 1 time. Now it locks in, it stops flashing. It's not activated yet, but now I've selected it to go. Press the set button 1 more time, goes back to the beginning, 2-00. At that point, you will hear all the valves in this unit start clicking. They're all opening up. Your unit may be running when you walk up to it, and that's perfectly fine. Your compressors are soft to coast down, all the valves will go open, and all of your indoor stats will go to a test mode where the end user, the tenant in the space, can't come mess with your thermostats and mess you up while you're doing your job. They'll be locked out. They'll have a display saying the system is in test. Now you can pull your vacuums, you can recover your refrigerant, pull your vacuums, remove your compressor, do all that good stuff. One thing to note about this mode, do not cycle power to the condenser. It turns the mode off if you cycle the high voltage to this condenser. So if you happen to do that, if you forget to do something, you've got to power it down, just remember to follow that, go back through the steps, put in forced recovery. App helps. You also hear the audible clicking of the valves to know you're in there.
Hey, Brian, one question. Yes. What about the expansion valves back at the air handling units? Are they going to open up too?
They're going to open up. That's a great question. Branch selector boxes, expansion valves at indoor units, it opens every valve in the entire system. So when you recover that gas and weigh it, you know the gas you got out was everything that was in the system. So if somebody's done a startup and they've tagged on here, it's supposed to have 80 pounds of gas and you only pull 65, you got another problem on your hands now. You got a refrigerant leak. So that's a great question. It opens every valve throughout the entire system and leaves them open until you either take it out of this mode through your buttons where you cycle power to the outdoor unit.
That's great. Thanks, Brian. Hey, thanks for joining us, Mechanical Pros. Come back for VRV tips. You probably can't get anywhere else. And hit that like, hit the subscribe, and we'll see you next time.